people ask me, as if I know what I'm doing, what's important in winning the Nobel Prize. And one of the key things which I thought was important is that you shouldn't be unfriendly to people from Scandinavia. That would clearly go against your best interests.
If you're a science person and you don't have a wicked sense of humor, you're not going to last. Everyone says, "Well, what was your most breathtaking moment? When he received the prize? When the trumpet?" I said, "No. When they plugged his computer into the world, and he went live." And I thought, "Dear God, please let the PowerPoint run." And he did. He gave the best talk he's ever given, because it was warm and it was witty and it was technically based.
Science is also art. How do you continue to push the envelope of this scientific art?
You carry that thrill of seeing what is beyond the boundaries of what one has tried.
You can ask yourself, what is the limit? How can I make measurements continue to improve the precision by, say, 17 digits, 18 digits, 19 digits? Where is the limit? How well can you measure the time? You can argue that's a philosophical question. It's also a physics question.
Where else do you find three Nobel laureates in 4 years in offices adjacent to each other? To me, it's a puzzlement.
It can't be all bad that people from all over the earth want to come and work in these labs and learn stuff.
Our students are very much in demand to work in some case, found local high-tech companies. We're inventing new stuff, we're developing new knowledge, we're passing it along, we're sending it out into the world. I think that's exactly what a university is about. And JILA, right here in the middle of University of Colorado, I think we're really a central part of this university.